The Philippine government now studying the possibility of holding a charter change plebiscite alongside the 2025 midterm elections. This is according to President Marcos, who proposed holding the plebiscite during the next elections to allow government to save money. The chief executive says his administration is assessing if the move would be practical.
Mag-o-organize na, kasi yung plebisito parang election din yan eh. We're studying it and I think there's a potential there that we can possibly exploit. So we'll see. It really comes down to a practical thing. It's very hard also to have a plebiscite before the election kasi mabubulilyaso yung preparation para sa halalan.
The Philippine poll body earlier welcomed the president's proposal. It says the move will have no bearing on its ongoing preparations for the 2025 polls.
Kung hiwalay po, 13 billion ang plebisito, sapagkat remember, ang isang plebisito ay involve ang national voters natin dito sa bansa at involve din ang overseas Filipino voters abroad. And therefore, para ka nagpapa-eleksyon ng barangay ng SK, kailangan mo ng 13 bilyon. Masyadong malaki po yun. Samantala kung sinama mo, wala kang gastos. Maliban na lang kung maglalambing po ang inyong commission election na baka pwede kang madagdagan naman kahit 2,000 piso ang bawat isang guro na magsisilbi sa araw ng eleksyon. Kung sakasakali po, medyo hahaba lang po ng konti ang ating pong balota, subalit ito po'y wala magiging karagdagan sa ating pong gastos, wala pong karagdagan sa mga supplies at iba pang gamit.
A Philippine lawmaker meanwhile raising concerns over the possible holding of the charter change plebiscite alongside the midterm polls. Lano del Sur Representative Zia Alonto Adyong fears such a move could politicize the issue, with candidates possibly using charter change as part of their platforms. Still, he says the House is sticking to its March deadline of finalizing proposed amendments to the economic provisions of the charter.
My personal take on this is that once we subject that to the referendum in 2025, probably it may create more problems and more delays. Because once we resume session in July, the president will be delivering his SONA. Congress, both houses, the Senate and the House of Representatives, will be busy tackling the national expenditure program, the budget for 2025. And there won't be simply enough time for us to sit down and discuss the merits of this proposal. I'm looking at probably have this done in within the year, maybe last quarter of this year. Why not? If we can do it within the year, why wait until 2025?
A controversial phrase takes center stage in the latest debates in Congress. Two former Supreme Court justices give opposing views on the use of the words "unless otherwise provided by law" in current efforts to amend the charter. Retired Supreme Court Chief Justice Renato Puno believes the phrase raises a red flag since it empowers lawmakers to amend the charter without a plebiscite.
Yun po sila sabing maaari maging ang constitutional aspect. Dahil lahat ng constitution natin, pagdating sa pagbabago ng konstitusyon, any change in period, change in punctuation, kailangan aprubahan ng tao. Itong batas na gagawin ng Kongreso, hindi po isasubmit yan sa Kongreso eh. Hindi sasubmit sa COMELEC, at yung COMELEC hindi sasubmit sa tao para aprubahan o disaprubahan. It's just to do away with this phrase "unless otherwise provided by law." Repeal this three restrictive provisions of the Constitution which you want to be out.
But for former Supreme Court Associate Justice Adolfo Ascona, lawmakers just have to be very precise in where they insert the controversial phrase. Unlike Puno, Ascona is not in favor of a blanket deletion of the supposed restrictive economic provisions in the Charter.
That may be dangerous, Madam Chair. We should regulate the entry of foreign investment rather than be totally silent about it. There should be a framework for the entry of foreign investment, and the framework that we have now should be maintained in the Constitution, only it should be adjustable by legislation. It does not mean that the law can amend the Constitution. It's simply operationalizing what the Constitution has already allowed, that a law may be passed to provide a different arrangement that is pursuant to a power given in the Constitution itself.
The debate comes as the House of Representatives continues their deliberations on charter change. Both chambers of Congress suggest inserting the controversial phrase to amend some parts of the 1987 Constitution.